McEnroe is still leading, though behind in this game. This is break point.
In. You call that in?
Oh, he doesn't
that
like that.
Out. What is wrong with you? Are you blitzed or something, you moron?
Hey, John. Why so jumpy?
Just trying to stay psyched.
Maybe it's the coffee you're drinking.
I'm drinking Gatorade.
Gatorade? Here, try some of this.
John, it's business. Your penalties are $20,000. Your winnings are $15,000. You're operating at a deficit.
Oh, shut up, Dad. I'm sick of your logic. I ain't another coffee.
And what's with all this coffee all of a sudden?
Look, it calms me down, all right?
You're losing!
Yeah, and that really bugs you, doesn't it?
Hey, calm down, the two of you.
What the hell are you doing here?
It's 3 weeks later. I always come back 3 weeks later.
You're the one that's got him drinking
all this
coffee.
That's none of your business. Just leave him alone. What?
What?
What happened?
Let's do it again, please. It's our fault.
What is wrong with you people? How many takes of this do we have to do?
We're all tired, Mr. McEnroe. Could we just try it again before we break?
Well, just get it right this time, all right?
John.
Morons.
Pardon me, Mr. McEnroe.
You heard what I said. I called you morons. I wasn't talking to myself.
All right. That's coffee. 15, everyone.
John, these endorsements are worth a lot of money,
so
all right?
So what? I don't care about them.
So what? They're important to me.
Yes, to who? To you?
Yes, to me.
That's right.
I'm not making
yeah, money. We'll just drink. What is this? I set this up.
Tired of ordinary television? Don't touch that dial. SCTV is now on the air. Starring John Candy, Joe Flaherty, Eugene Levy, Andrea Martin, Rick Moranis, Catherine O'Hara, and Dave Thomas. Television like you've never seen it before. This is the SCTV Television Network with special guest Dr. John.
No more time.
No fairy, you're eating while I'm doing the feed. Okay, I'm eating. Give me that, eh?
Okay.
Go ahead, do the topic.
Okay. Good day, how's it going? I'm Bob McKenzie, and this is my brother Doug.
How's it going, eh?
We're real hungry today, because our topic is like carpets. Okay, so like, we like drove around, right? And we got like this lady was getting like new carpets in her house, right? So like she had all this stuff out like right in the ditch, right? Like pieces of carpet, like some were this big and long, some were like that big and like square, right? So like we put it all up on like the walls of the van. Okay, so that's the topic. What are you doing?
Making a sandwich. Keep talking.
Oh, you're flipping tomato seeds at me, eh? Here, look, right in your eye. What are you having? Here.
It's like bacon, lettuce, and tomato.
You got bacon on there? Only okay, so like when you're putting
back bacon.
When you're putting carpets in the van, make sure that you use like enough glue. Okay, that's the show for today. So good day.
Good day.
Oh no, come on.
What?
You shouldn't talk with your mouth full.
Wait a minute.
Hold it. So that's the show. So. How's it going? Everything, so, okay. So that's the show for today, so good day.
Good day.
Movies! We got lots of them here at SCTV. And our own Johnny LaRue will be producing, directing, and starring in 36 of them. One you'll be seeing in just a few minutes. And one he's working on right now. It's called Chicks in Their Underwear. Chicks in Their Underwear. Should be a good one. Let's watch a genius at work.
Mr. LaRue is here.
Go.
Good morning, Mr. LaRue.
Yeah.
Lights, camera, action.
Oh, Miles, I.
Cut, print it. That's a wrap.
LaRue, come here.
Hello, Edith. Welcome to the set.
Oh, nice of you to have me. What the hell are you calling a wrap?
My creative juices just aren't flowing today.
Blowing up Lake Athabasca if you don't get on with it.
Get off my back quickly or I'll flatten you. I got a casting session. Let's go!
Wait a minute. John- Johnny LaRue. Genius. Temperamental, but genius.
Hey, you, take your clothes off.
Who, me?
No, not you.
Why not? Roll it, George. Why not?
Now, the SCTV Movie of the Week, starring Johnny LaRue.
The name's Johnny LaRue. I'm a restaurateur, and I've opened restaurants all over this great world of ours. I opened a Polynesian restaurant once. After a bad experience, I swore I'd never go back. But here I am, back in Polynesiantown.
Song, Chuck.
Thanks, Johnny.
Nice hair.
Enough with the hair!
All right. Testy little creep. Enjoy yourselves. Hi, Vic.
Hi, Johnny. Going pretty good, huh?
Going very good.
Gobs of tuna's going like hotcakes.
So I hear.
Oh, Johnny, those restaurant critics are outside?
Yeah.
What should I do with them?
Send them in, Vic. Send them in.
Sure.
Come on in, boys.
Hiya, boys.
Hey, it's an exciting night, Johnny. Who's the main act?
I got a Polynesian singer by the name of Dr. Don. I got some other fine acts for you, too.
Say, Johnny.
What kind of food
can we expect?
Hawaiian ribs, boys, with that special Molokai sauce. Why, there's your angle, boys. Play up those ribs.
Are the drinks on the house?
No.
Too bad.
Johnny, you're gonna get bad reviews. Come on, boys.
Come on, boys. Come on back. I was just kidding. You cheap punks. I blew with a press, Vic.
Yeah, well, look, John, there's some sort of misunderstanding here.
What do you mean?
The singer we booked, his name isn't Dr. Don, it's Dr. John.
What?
That's right, and he don't sing Polynesian. He sings rock and roll.
What do you mean he sings rock and roll? This is a Polynesian restaurant, Vic.
Oh, I ought to fire you, Vic. Oh, look, I'm sorry, Johnny.
You're sorry. Boy, if you hadn't saved my life in the 60s.
Yeah, I did, too.
Yeah, I know you did. I ought to...
Hey, Johnny. Snap out of it.
Come on, the entertainment's about ready to start.
Yeah, the entertainment. I do the slapping around here. I gotta go talk to this Dr. Don or whatever his name is.
John. Dr. John.
I hope he sings some Hawaiian song.
Here she is, ladies and gentlemen, Big Mama.
Thank you very much. You're too kind. You're too kind. I'd like to sing a little song that's one of my favorites, and I hope one of yours. Happy Talk!
Talk about the moon floating in the sky, looking like a lily on the lake.
Now, for the last time, I'm telling you, I ain't wearing no grass skirts, and I ain't singing no tiny bubbles, neither.
All right, you don't have to sing tiny bubbles. I'll give you that. But what's wrong with a grass skirt? I wear one, damn it, and they're manly. Look, I got movement here. You'll need one of those out on stage.
Man, the only reason I took this gig is our old Vic Hedges, man, for saving my life back in the 70s.
He saved your life, too? He saved my life back in the 60s. Vic Hedges, he's a hell of a guy. Now look, Dr. John, surely as a physician you must realize those people came here to hear Polynesian songs. That's what they're here for.
Look, I can't take any more of this from you, LaRue.
Happy Talk. Talk about things you like to do. You got the...
What the hell's going on here? Don't you know talent when you see it? You're bums. You're nothing but bums. That's all you...
Excuse me, Doc.
Thanks.
All right, that does it. I'm never playing this dive again. Those people out there are animals. Let them lose their souls. Now, where are the ribs you promised me?
In the back alley. Go on.
Big Mama's hungry.
I ought to Big Mama you.
She goes, I go too.
No, Dr. John, please. This crowd, they're ready for you. They want you. Look. All right, they're a little rough. But they want you. Come on, feast your eyes out here. Fuck me, I'll let them down.
Hey,
for that dame over there. You ever see such a haunting mug?
Yeah, I've seen it at a couple of my concerts. Okay, I'll do it.
You will. You won't regret it, I swear.
Yeah, but first, I want you to take care of these gems.
Gems?
Yeah, gems. I collect them.
Gems. I'll take care of them immediately. I'll put them in a safe place. But first, I'll introduce you. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the Hawaiian song stylings, the rock and roll song stylings of Dr. John. Come on.
Such a night. Such a night. Sweet confusion under the moonlight. Such a night. It's such a night. Got to steal away, yeah. The time seemed right. Baby, your eyes met mine at a glance. You let me know this was my chance. You came here with my best friend Jim. Here I am just trying to steal you away from him. If I don't do it, somebody else will. If I don't do it, somebody else will. If I don't do it, somebody else will. If I don't do it, somebody sure will. And it's such a night. Such a night. Sweet confusion. The time seemed right. Such a night. Such a night. Got to steal away, yeah. Yeah, and in a dark side. And baby, I couldn't believe my ears. My heart just skipped a beat. Told me we could slip away, yeah, yeah. Down the dark end of the street, you came here with my best friend Jim. Here I am just trying to steal you away from him. If I don't do it, somebody else will. 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 And it's such a night. Such a night.
What's wrong with ribs?
The ribs went bad.
What are you trying to tell me?
It's that special Molokai sauce, I think. It affected the whole batch.
Oh, it can't be as bad as all that, can it, Vic?
Take a look out there.
What seems to be wrong? They're enjoying themselves.
Yeah, now. But in 15 minutes, they're gonna be sick. Bad sick.
We gotta warn Dr. John. Come on, Vic.
Yeah, let's go tell him.
Man, it's the best snack I've had in a long time, man. These ribs were delicious, man. This sauce was cold-blooded, too, man. Yeah, made me feel like playing now.
No, you don't have to if you don't want to.
Man, I'm in the mood now.
Why don't you call it a night, maybe? All right, we gotta work fast.
Today, we'll be following me through a typical day. To examine the two hemispheres of my brain.
Coming soon on SCTV, it's Walter Cronkite's Brain, with David Brinkley.
Sorry, David. I almost forgot to pick you up.
Cronkite and Brinkley on SCTV.
What's the matter? Can't you take it?
Walter, I can understand you wanting to win.
Coming soon to SCTV, Ted Gordon, overbooked attorney, a lawyer with a caseload that would break a Clydesdale's back.
Well, Mr. Turkell, if you have no case for the defense, I'm going to have to pass sentence.
Oh, please, Your Honor, just a few more minutes. My lawyer promised he'd be here.
Sorry, I'm late.
Where the hell were you?
Sorry. Sorry, Your Honor, I was in courtroom G with a nitpicking jury. Don't worry, Mr. Williams, I'll
Turkell!
Turkell, right. Okay, take a seat. Ah, so, Your Honor, if it would please the court, I'd like to ask for an adjournment.
Mr. Gordon, would you approach the bench? The court realizes what a busy man you are. But you've already adjourned this case 9 times!
Am I to take that as a no, Your Honor?
Ted Gordon, you're overdue in courtroom R.
Excuse me, Your Honor. Let's go to courtroom R. Ask the defendant to read this. Tell him I'm sorry I couldn't be there. Just tell him to read it.
How are you doing, Gordon?
Just relax.
Mr. Gordon, might I remind you that we are in courtroom H, and we're conducting a trial here?
Yes, of course, Your Honor.
Is there Ted Gordon in here?
Yeah, right here.
Here's your pizza. We was out of pepperoni. I used
some
bacon.
Thanks a lot. That's great.
There you go. Thanks. Oh, I don't know if I can change
this. Keep the change.
Hey, thanks, Mr. Gordon.
Okay, Your Honor, I'd like to ask the court's indulgence. Could we read back the transcripts of the last, say, 2 or 3 minutes?
Read the transcripts.
Judge, Mr. Turkle, I'm sorry. If you have no case for the defense, I must pass sentence. Turkle, please, Your Honor, just a few more minutes. My lawyer promised he'd be here. Judge, you're very sure of that, Mr. Turkle?
What's going on here? Gordon, you're making a mockery of this court.
Oh, I see. But it's okay for me to go without lunch. Is that the idea, Your Honor? Well, fine. I'll skip my case for the defense and go right to my summation.
Ladies and gentlemen of the jury.
There is no jury.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen of the court.
I appeal to you.
This isn't for me. This is for you, Gordon. Seems you have a jet waiting to take you to Los Angeles. You have a trial there at 3:00.
That's right. Your Honor, I must insist that this trial have a change of venue. It must be reconvened in Los Angeles this afternoon. Make all the necessary arrangements. Have the defendant and the witnesses sent there. What?
Absolutely not. I find the defendant guilty, and Gordon, I find you in contempt of court.
Well, Your Honor, you're gonna have to catch me first. If you had any brains, you'd be running with me.
What's going on?
Ted Gordon, overbooked attorney. People called him a workaholic, but the fact is, he was just plain greedy.
And now, part 2 of Polynesiantown.
Thank you, thank you. I have an announcement to make. There's some bad ribs going around. Oh, nobody eat these ribs. Hey, he's got my gems.
Hey, Vic, what are you doing? Don't worry, I'll take care of him. You okay, Chuck?
I'm okay, Johnny.
Nice hair.
Stop with the hair!
All right, come on, let's go get him. Where'd he go?
Johnny! Dr. John! Look out!
Vic! Vic!
Oh, Johnny!
It's me, Johnny!
Dr. John, I'm sorry. Your gems, Dr. John.
Keep them, Vic.
Can I have them? Sure, Johnny. Thanks. I won't need them where I'm going. Oh, Johnny,
kind of ironic, isn't it?
How's that?
Well, me being hit by a rib truck.
I don't get it.
Well, you know, I tried to kill everybody by poisoning the ribs, and then I was hit by a rib truck.
What's the point?
Look! That's a rib truck, isn't it?
Yeah.
I tried to kill everybody by poisoning them with ribs.
Yeah?
And it hit me.
So?
The irony, man, the irony.
There's that mysterious dame again.
Say, who are you? What do you want?
Are you talking to me? Dr. John is really talking to me. Finally, I am in the right place at the right time. I can't believe it. Please take me to your Tango Palace and shower me with Gree-Gree. Please, I love you, Mac. Mu minus U equals loneliness.
Please. Will someone please have this woman put to sleep?
Chuck her. Please, no. No, I'm the Funkadilla baby, the thriller from Manila. Great Concord.
What a day. I lost my business. I lost my best friend. And I lost my pants.
Forget it, LaRue. This is Polynesiantown.
All right, back up there. Come on, back up. Come on, back up. Go on back up to the sidewalk.
Did you get that irony bit? Or the ribs?
Come on, Holmes. What's up, Holmes?
Yeah. Maybe you could explain it to me.
Well, you know, like, I mean, he poisoned the ribs and I got hit by a rib truck and died, you know? I mean, it's ironical. And, you know, he was dying, you know? He was like,
No, I saw that. I understood that part.
You know, it's like, the ribs, you know?
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe it's me. It's been a long day.
Yeah. Maybe you could give Vic a big send off.
No. He'd want it cheap. He was always a cheap guy. But he'd save your life in a minute. But he'd also try to stab you in the back real fast, too.
That's Vic for you.